for the ones that think I'm joking. Yeah, this for real, for real. Lightweight bust off half a passel. Yeah, I'm sweating, baby. Must be all them happy meals. I don't know how happy feels, but damn, I'm trying to find you. Say I got sex appeal. I think it's cause I work out. Got a gun, I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none. I'm stuck in my ways. They say I'm the chosen one. See it in my face. Get this one and I'm holding on. I can't be replaced. I just take a shit when it's spit. We on chat.
They don't know my name. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go. But I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah, look at me, at the asylum. Was a fatal mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Got a reflux, I drip out from the socket to a teacup. Drink up inside, look when they peep us. Jesus in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black Hawk, see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising, thinking. What type of knowledge don't sink in? Life gives you lemons and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage. Way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze. On each and every way, put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.
I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't around here. I'm the goat, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I whip the cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay, hit that. just a stone's throw from historic Monument Circle in downtown Indianapolis. We are at the beautiful Loop.
For the wins, came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins and the world's still spinning. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Hey, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my dance.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Hoosier State and Lucas Oil Stadium in downtown Indianapolis. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the New Orleans Saints and the Indianapolis Colts. The holiday season is upon us. We've got the gift of the NFL as we're underway here in Week 16. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. They'll run. This is Jonathan Taylor. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
6-yard pickup brings up second and four.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31.
Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Looking to throw. Kyle dancing to his left. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target. And it's second down.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Ready. 13 yards remaining on second down. To throw. Kyle flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Off the play fake. Kyle. blitz coming, and down he goes. Marcus Davenport in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him.
2 sacks last week, another one right here. He's been unblockable lately, and I think that goes all the way back to not just his offseason, but the film study he's been doing during the week, because I think he's found matchups that he likes, and he's capitalizing.
And a few times he's even defeated double teams. He doesn't care at this point. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
An early message that this secondary is going to be tested, because even though it fell incomplete, it almost felt like a warning shot to get things going.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Operating from the gun, Kyle. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on 3rd down.
So on 4th down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. He's taken down at the 23.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's a 2nd and 7. Darius Leonard make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Well, the pass rush has been a real strength of late. They know how to get after the quarterback.
Absolutely. 4 sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles. But also when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme their way back to the quarterback as well.
He's going to air one out. He's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Saints 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. In today's NFL, you know, we talk about quarterbacks and their speed and accuracy, but there's still something about a guy slinging one downfield. So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. They'll run. This is Kamara. They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of 2.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. He'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
The line to gain is the 33 on 3rd down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's going to sling this deep downfield into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Julian Blackman. And it's a good return here as he'll get all the way up close to the 35.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. He missed on his first three passes. Passes was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection. Maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you're wondering, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races.
On first and 10. Kyle steps away to his left. He gets this into the hands of Taylor. 7 yards on the play, and it'll make it second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Looking to throw on second down. Kyle flushed out right. That's complete to Jonathan Taylor out of the backfield. No gain on that one, and it's going to bring up a third down. They rolled out of the pocket right, and I think he wanted a little something more out of that play, obviously. Instead, he hit a safety valve.
It looked like two well-coached teams there, even though there was no yardage gain, because the offensive guys, hey, they realized their quarterback was out of the pocket. All the receivers went to the right spots, tried to get in his sight line, tried to open themselves up. Just nowhere to go where they could gain yardage. How about the defensive guys, though? Did not lose leverage and kept their poise and made a really nice play.
Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. On first down. Kyle, under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Just not much a quarterback can do there, CD. The pressure was in his face almost instantaneously, led to a very quick sack.
And this came from the edge, and those pass rushers, they have so many tricks of the trade to get around blockers. They have a lot of tools in their kit. This was pure speed and athleticism on this play, though, and they could barely get a glove on him before he got the quarterback on the ground.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Looking to throw. Kyle. Throwing middle, and it's complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. Back to throw. Kyle. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off down near the 5. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. No doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room that if you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. On 2nd down, Kamara. And they'll get him down up past the 15. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Well, CD, a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but, man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. A gain of six there on first.
Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys on plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive. It just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. It's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1-2-3, this is where the ball goes anymore.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara, and he'll get it down here to the 43. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Great way to convert on third down there, 21 yards the play.
First down.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Forced out to his left, and that is incomplete here. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Passing game, and he's taken down after a gain of 3 as they move it from the 22 to the 19. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead. The Saints on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. The Colts D sticking to their assignments, and that brings up 4th.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on 3rd down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected 4th down here.
With a field goal, a 36-yard attempt.
The kick by Lutz is good. And the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Parker, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you 6?
Following the made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 11 yards there, first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. And it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Eluding the pressure right.
He'll get that one to Taylor complete.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Off play action. Kyle. Rush coming in. He's taken down. CD, you know, so often we talk about quarterbacks holding on to the ball too long. Well, we can't say that there. He had no time to do much of anything.
Yeah, that's one where you turn to your lineman and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely because, remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
And according to our friends with Next Gen Stats, that sack occurred in a mere 2.1 seconds. Good luck trying to avoid that.
I thought they were going to sack him there like they did on first down. Great coverage, but he found a way to move with his legs.
Yeah, his ability to take off, not only did he get some yardage back, he got a little bit extra. Really helps him on third down. Makes it manageable now.
Buying time to his left. He may try. The ball comes out, and this is picked up by the Saints. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Good job starting on that scramble. Had his eyes on that first down marker, CD, but lost the most important thing, the football.
Yeah, wasn't quite there. Focused solely on getting to the first down marker. Forgot to cover up and take care of the ball.
A good starting spot for the Saints as they come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
First down carry, it's Kamara. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory.
Kari Willis there to bring him down.
Second and 5. He'll find his tight end, it's Adam Troutman. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. A play fake as they set up to throw. That is caught at the 7. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans.
Laviska Shenault.
His third touchdown now on the year. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further.
I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play. And that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off.
Fielded near the back of the end zone.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And last time the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Throwing again, Kyle.
That's complete to his running back, Taylor.
And he'll be out right at the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the gun, Kyle. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. The final shot before break. Kyle escaping the pressure right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So we are at halftime here on Christmas Eve. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Mitch Wisnowski set to kick off.
Set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Adam Trautman, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Kamara found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A first down and then some. Give him 29 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. A quick throw complete into the flat out left. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot,
You often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Working with second and five now.
A play action fake. They'll look to throw. His throw incomplete.
Charlie Werner, the tight end, the intended target.
And it's third down. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open. And it would have been an easy drop.
The Colts D sticking to their assignments, and that brings up fourth.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
A 47-yard attempt.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle, and that will bump up the lead again to 12-0. So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
Taken about 7 yards deep, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt a return.
25-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Flush to his right. He'll find Taylor. That's complete. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll make it third down. He felt the pressure coming there. That was a good job of just making something out of nothing, so to speak.
Yeah, took the hit and still made the play. You know, when we talk about runners, all right, and on running plays, runs after contact, we call that getting dirty yards, tough, gritty ones. To me, that's like the version of a dirty pass. He knows he's going to get smacked, yet still delivers the football and picks up good yardage.
And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away.
And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
Second and 9 now from the 21. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Adam Trautman, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. That's to his running back, it's Alvin Kamara. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards.
That's another beautiful throw right there. It gets it to his man right in stride. And I think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm. They've been sharp. They've been on it. And they pick up another first down there.
Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one.
The Saints, first down.
Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10, down at the 33. on the ground, Kamara. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. Credit the tackle there to Uchenna Nwosu.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
He sets to fire deep. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints.
That's it, baby. That's it.
A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie. Because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
They're on the 17-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Flushed out right. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Dangerous spot for them to cough it up. Lucky to have recovered because had the defense gotten it, they were already within the shadow of the goalpost.
Yeah, and then you're yelling at your own defense, sudden change. That's not what you want to hear on your sideline. That means you've got to run out there and try and stop an offense who has the ball in a very advantageous position.
Trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And it's a big turnover there on the final play of the quarter. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Trying to pound it in, Kamara. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints' touchdown. Alvin Kamara, his 26th touchdown, drawing even with Marshall Faulk for the fourth most in a single season. And the Saints take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash in for six. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go.
26, Colts nothing.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Taken about 7 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Off the play fake, Kyle. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's 3rd down. The Colts on 3rd down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. Here it's 3rd and 3. He's got his tight end, Burton. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll be a gain of 17 and an Indianapolis 1st down.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Looking to throw. Kyle. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off near the 42. And the return. return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December.
Season of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep
through an opening, and there he goes. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara with touchdown number 27. That ties Priest Holmes for the 3rd most in a single year. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points. And this one through the uprights and good.
Saints 33, Colts nothing.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Taken in the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it?
And he's taken down here by the Saints. Marcus Davenport has now recorded 10 sacks on the season.
Back at the 16-yard line.
To throw on 2nd down, Kyle. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Throwing on 3rd and long, Kyle. And he connects with Ebron. 30, 20, 10. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Eric Ebron, 84 yards. And the Colts are able to cut into this lead. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no 0. Are you, you're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Saints take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. We find ourselves here in the midst of a one-sided affair. A lot of fill time down the stretch, Mr. Davis.
So we could talk about food, because that is something that you and I both enjoy.
We
enjoy our time at the table. So maybe the best steakhouses in the city, but in all seriousness, the performances that we've seen this year, we've seen a bunch of great ones, and it's going to be hard to parse who's going to win the MVP.
Yeah, it really is.
Is it going to be a runner? Is it going to be a thrower? Can a defender finally win it this season? Those are the things that we could probably discuss.
And collectively, this is about as dominant of a performance as you could have hoped for on both sides of the football.
Might have to put it 1 for what we've seen this season.
Again, it's Kamara. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
The Saints on 3rd down. They've hit 4 of 7. This time they face a 3rd and 2. A man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Kamara again. And boy, he is very close to a 1st down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys,
made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 14-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest. Now left side on the swing pass. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
Escaping the pressure right. To the right side to Eric Ebron. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Operating from the gun, Kyle. Being chased out left. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing on first down. Kyle dancing to his left. He'll try and run it. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. From the gun, Kyle flush to his right. Able to locate his running back, open downfield. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Jonathan Taylor with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Colts are able to draw a bit closer.
And that's another route the defenders would vote to take out of the game.
The wheel route?
Oh, without a doubt. You're just trying to move everybody in one direction. And whether it's a running back or another receiver, as they zip out behind the sideline, you've got a problem on your hands.
Yeah, well, the defenders hate it. There it happened, and it resulted in a touchdown. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Saints take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Second and 7.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They run it again with Kamara. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with 3rd down now looming.
And it's 3rd down.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And some room to maneuver. And he will finally be taken down, but not before he gets it to the Colts 34. Well, they only needed a small gain on 3rd down. They end up getting over 30 yards.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a 1st down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Brings up 2nd and 3.
That one looks like he'll throw here. No, he almost had it. Already with 1 interception, just missing his 2nd there.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Back to the ground, it's Kamara. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
First down, Saints.
So this one, a victory here for New Orleans. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.
So for the Saints, it's a critical win for them as it gets them to 9-6 on the year. And they'll get another road date next week. Meanwhile, for Indianapolis, they'll be guaranteed a finish of no better than 500 as they drop to 7-8. And they'll be at home next week for a date with the Tennessee Titans. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon, saying so long, everybody.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same, things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Hey, could count on my power and look at my dogs. Way back then, could claim what you saw, but you weren't with us. The higher the climb, the harder the fall, but how did you get up? I done got rich and went broke, then got rich again, just a little hiccup. I done been balling this pickup. Remember me being so bummy and being so hungry, I had to eat gristle. Ay, how did the little girl miss? Ay, how she with magic, she mixed. Met her at one of the functions, we caught her a rhythm. She caught up a friend, they kissed and we dipped it, and that's how we kicked it.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Before I went live, they ain't know what I was. Ain't no one alive that could do what I does. Need a light year to protect my buzz. He's right here to protect my car. Now they don't really talk about us. Now they don't really talk about love. Honestly, they ain't never seen too much. What's love to a guy with a bag? What's heart to a guy with some cash? What's pain to a guy that's mad? Said. What's broke to a guy with a mask? What's broke to a guy with a plan? I just wanna kick it, that's all I ask. Like.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?